What made you decide to come home, Dave?
Well, I guess the main thing that turned it all up was the Hungarian situation.
He wanted to see his mother, too.
And I wanted to see my mother.
Did you ever give up hope, Mrs. Jones?
I never did. I knew God would bring him back.
The concern is still pretty low, but according to previous Chinese standard, they are rather a great improvement, I should say.
Improvement over what they were before?
Yes.
What about your co-workers? Were they always friendly to you at all times?
Oh, yes, very friendly.
They were. I believe something's been said, or a great deal has been said, about the fact that you hope as soon as possible for your wife to join you. You still have high hopes that she will be able to?
Yes.
You see any reason why she would not?
No, I see no reason why she shouldn't be allowed to come in.
Sam, are you able to hear any news broadcasts or any news source of any type or kind besides the red radio over there?
Yes, I listen to Armed Forces Network, Voice of America, BBC, Australia.
This was all permitted by the Chinese, then?
Well, foreigners can obtain a permit to own a shortwave radio.
I see. Did you note any particular letdown of the red feeling after the Hungarian revolt, or was that generally known by the red Chinese people?
It was generally known, and there didn't seem to be any feelings one way or the other, not from what I myself observed.
Sam, in your opinion as an American observer in Red China, do you feel that the Red Chinese are thoroughly happy with their present way of life?
Yes, I would say so.
Do you think that this is due to the fact that they have been hoodwinked, or are they actually doing well economically, the average person?
Yes. I would say it was because their living conditions are much better than before. They've got enough to eat, they've got enough to wear, and they've got everyone's got a job.
Sam, what was your average breakfast over there?
I didn't eat breakfast.
You didn't eat breakfast at all?
No.
Was this by choice?
By choice.
What did you have for breakfast this morning, for instance?
Bacon and eggs and toast and milk, coffee.
How much milk?
Quart.
How many cups of coffee?
Three or four.
Well, that's a little bit better than nothing anyway.
Yeah.
Nobody had to push this breakfast at you, I imagine, though, either.
No.
Sam, what's the first thing you're going to do today now after we finish here?
I'm going to go shopping.
What are you going to shop for?
Clothes, specifically.
Clothes, specifically?
Yeah.
Any particular type of clothes?
Yeah, I want to get some Levi's and a couple of Okie shirts.
My new duties will require that I move to Dayton, Ohio, where I will have the supervision of the procurement and production activities of the Air Force. Whereas I have many duties in that field here at Tinker now, when I move to Dayton, I'll be responsible for the procurement and production for the entire Air Force, the biggest business in the world.
Mr. Schmidt, what will you manufacture at your plant here?
This will produce the modern crossbar electromechanical switching equipment, which is the media of transmission and switching for local telephone and long-distance service.
And what is the total expenditure to be on the plant?
Will approximate $35 million when completed and fully equipped.
How many persons will you employ, Mr. Smith?
Approximately 3,500.
And your annual payroll would be about what?
Something in the order of $14 to $15 million.
Where will your personnel come from?
Largely from Oklahoma City and Oklahoma. Obviously, in an operation of this magnitude, we will bring certain key personnel, but I wouldn't believe that would be more than a couple of hundred people. They're certainly coming from here.
Where will these people be trained, sir?
They will be trained on the job. We will have an initial training set up, which we choose to call pilot shop, which we expect to have in operation by the end of this year, where we'll train a nucleus of people, about 600, who in turn will be used as instructors and trainers for the ultimate shop.
Mr. Smith, what factors influenced your decision to come to Oklahoma City?
Well, there are a great many. I think the first and always the most important is the availability of a good, sound group of people. The type of people that we find here in Oklahoma, and the kind of people that we like to have as our employees.